Whoops, looks like we've taken a wrong turn here on our journey and ended up somewhere in the matrix. While we're here, let's talk about data types. Most variables have a data type. A data type defines the kind of data that can be stored in that variable. Common data types include numbers for any data that is numeric or should be worked with as a number for addition or other math operations. In our pet cafe, the number of pets is a number. String is for any data that is text, for example, a name or address or message. Strings require quotes. Notice that the text inside of the quotes can include spaces and other special characters. Date is for data that is a date or time, such as a birthday. And Boolean for any data that only has the value true or false. Like in a number guessing game, the user's guess was either correct or it wasn't. There is no other value. Another important type in programming is an array, which in some programming languages is called a list. Let's say we add a feature to our pet cafe so the user can name each of their virtual pets. We could store each name in a separate variable like these. But then we'd have to limit how many virtual pets we could allow so we'd know how many variables we'd need. Arrays solve this problem. An array is a collection or set of data items. You can think of a simple array as a list of items. The data items in an array are often of the same type, so an array of numbers of strings or an array of dates. Arrays are often defined with square brackets, and each value in the array is separated with commas. An array variable that stores each pet's name could look like this. Here we define an array of strings. Recall that strings must be enclosed in quotation marks. We can then allow the user to have an almost limitless number of names because we can keep appending to the array. Arrays are great whenever you're working with more than one item. But what about data that represents things in our application? Things like a pet, customer, product, or post. And I actually mean a social media post here, but close enough. How do we specify the data types of these objects? First, we identify the data we want to track for each of the objects. These are often characteristics of the object, like a pet's name, type, and age. In programming, each of these are a property of the object. For a customer, the properties are the customer's name, shipping address, and default payment method, and so on. Next, we define a name for each property, like this. Each of these properties has a data type. Names are strings, age is a number, and in stock is a Boolean value, true or false. We could keep track of separate variables for each of these pet properties, and each of these customer properties, and each of these product properties, but we'd end up with lots of unorganized variables. We can instead group each set of related properties into what's called an object. We group the properties of an object often within curly braces. This keeps the data for an object together and makes it easier to work with it as a set. This variable is the object and represents a specific pet. Inside the braces, each property for the pet has a name, a colon, and a value. We separate properties with a comma. Here we defined a pet object with a specific set of properties and a value for each property. Same with the customer, and so on. This brings us to our next tip. Use an object to group related properties. Let's stop here for a moment and think about objects. What's your favorite hobby? If you wrote a program to support that hobby, what objects might you define? Maybe you like to bake, so you'd build a recipe app with your favorite recipes. You work with the data for each recipe using an object with properties such as ingredients, recipe steps, baking temperature, and time. Or say you like sports. You'd track the data for each player using an object with properties such as name, position, and stats. And you'd track the data for each game using another object with properties such as teams and score. What objects did you define for your hobby? So, a variable has a data type, such as number, string for text, date, and Boolean for true or false. An array stores a set of data items, often of the same type. Here is an array of strings. An object represents something in the application, like a pet, a customer, or a blog post. The object groups related properties holding the data for the object. Each object property has a name and value, like this. Each of our variables holds local data. But when the program ends, all local data is gone. Where do we put data we want to keep or share with other users?